Hello everyone, myself Dr. Harishankar Singh. In this video, we will discuss about the magnetic flux density that is denoted by B. So let's start here. The magnetic flux density is similar to the electric flux density D, as we have already discussed in the electrostatics. As we know, D is equal to epsilon naught E and it is defined in the free space. Similarly, the magnetic flux density B is related to the magnetic field intensity H, and we can write B is equal to mu naught H, where mu naught is the constant and it is known as permeability of the free space. Its unit is the Henry per meter and it has value mu naught is equal to 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. Therefore, the magnetic flux through a surface S is given by psi is equal to surface integral B dot ds, where the magnetic flux psi has the unit Weber and the magnetic flux density has unit Weber per meter square, or you can say Tesla. A magnetic flux line is a path to which B is tangential at every point on the line. It is a line along which the needle of magnetic compass will orient itself if placed in the presence of magnetic field. The direction of B is taken as that indicates as north by the needle of the magnetic compass. Look at this figure. The magnetic flux lines due to the straight long wire are shown here. The flux line are determined by the using same principle followed for the electric flux line, as we have discussed in the electrostatic, which I have already discussed in the previous videos. As you can see in this figure, each flux line is closed and has no beginning or end, and do not cross to each other, regardless of the current distribution. Now, in an electrostatic field, the flux passing through a closed surface is the same as the charge enclosed by the surface. So we can write psi is equal to closed surface integral D dot ds, and this will be equal to Q. Thus, it is possible to have an isolated electric charge as shown in this figure, such that flux lines are not necessarily closed. In this figure, you can see the positive charge is placed and it is enclosed by the surface. Here, the electric field lines are in the outward direction. So if we have the isolated charge, either positive or negative, electric field line will be always there. That will be in the outward direction or inward direction respectively. Now look at this second figure. Unlike electric field lines, magnetic flux lines always closed upon themselves. So the total flux through a closed surface in a magnetic field must be zero. That is, psi is equal to closed integral B dot ds, and this is equal to zero. Therefore, it is not possible to have an isolated magnetic poles or magnetic charges. Suppose if we desire to have an isolated magnetic pole, by dividing a magnetic bar successively into two, we end up with the pieces each having north and south poles, as shown in this figure. Let's make 2, 4, 8 or many more pieces. Each piece will have north and south pole. Therefore, it is impossible to separate the north pole from the south pole. So we can say an isolated magnetic pole never exists. Thus, the total flux through a closed surface in a magnetic field must be zero. That is, closed surface integral B dot ds will be equal to zero. This equation is referred to as law of conservation of magnetic flux, or you can say Gauss law of magnetostatic field. Although the magnetostatic field is not conservative, magnetic flux is conserved. By applying the divergence theorem and changing the surface integral into the volume integral, we can write closed surface integral B dot ds is equal to volume integral del dot B dv, and this is equal to zero. So we can write del dot B is equal to 0. And this is again a Maxwell equation. These two equations shows that magnetostatic fields have no source or sinks. And del dot B is equal to 0 suggests that magnetic field lines are always continuous. Now, whatever we have learned and discussed in the previous videos for the static fields, that is the electrostatic and magnetostatic, we got all four Maxwell equations for the static fields. So here you can see all four Maxwell equations is given in the differential form and in the integral form. So Gauss law of electrostatics and magnetostatics give two laws of Maxwell. That is, in the electrostatics, we will have del dot D is equal to rho V. And in the integral form, we can write closed surface integral D dot ds is equal to volume integral rho V dV. Whereas, Gauss law of magnetostatics suggests that del dot B is equal to 0. And in the integral form, we can write closed surface integral B dot ds is equal to 0. And it means isolated magnetic poles never exist. And the third Maxwell equation says that del cross E is equal to 0. It means conservative nature of electric fields. In the integral form, we can write closed line integral E dot dl over contour C will be equal to 0. This is only valid for the static field. And the fourth Maxwell equation, that is the Ampere's law, suggests that del cross H is equal to J. And in the integral form, closed line integral H dot dl over contour C is equal to surface integral J dot ds. So the choice between differential and integral forms of the equation depends on the given problem. Always remember that these Maxwell equations as given in this table are only for the static electric field and static magnetic fields. The divergence equation will remain the same for the time varying electromagnetic field, but curl equation will have to be modified. I will discuss all these equations in details when we will study about the Maxwell equations, and we will discuss in the upcoming videos. Thank you for watching this video.